أعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده، لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه، مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد، وسلم تسليما كثيرا. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد، الله أكبر كبيرا، والحمد لله كثيرا، وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا، لا إله إلا الله وحده، صدق وعده، ونصر عبده، وأعز جنده، وهزم الأحزاب وحده، لا إله إلا الله، ولا نعبد إلا إياه، مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد، وسلم تسليما كثيرا.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My dear brothers and sisters, welcome to Britain's first mosque on the blessed day of Eid. On behalf of the trustees and the management, I'd like to wish everyone here and across the globe a very happy Eid Mubarak. Eid Mubarak. Jazakumullah khair. I hope you had a beautiful Ramadan. Ramadan came and gone so quickly before our eyes. You were able to perfect yourself, did lots of siyam, qiyam, and ibadah. Please keep it that way as you have done in this blessed month of Ramadan. I'd like to say Jazakumullah khair, Barakallah feekum for your beautiful support throughout the Ramadan. We were feeding 300 to 500 people every day for iftar. And it's because of you, my brothers, your contribution. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept and give you barakah in abundance. Jazakumullah khair for all the sadaqah that you have given. May he give you reward for everything that you have done for this masjid. Jazakumullah khair. I just would like to say a couple of things. Some of you already know, and some of you may not know, that we are embarking on purchasing the music shop that you'll see on the right-hand side of the white building, which used to be Abdullah Kulliyah Masjid 135 years ago. So they prayed in that masjid. And if you look at the poster here, you'll see this is the music shop. It says Rima's Music, right next to the old the white building. And that is a private ownership. It used to be Abdullah Kulliyah's 135 years ago, but it's no longer. And it's up for sale. It's at £500,000. The market value is about £700,000. So we're getting at a very good price, and we must purchase this in order to create a new Kulliyah Masjid. Everybody's praying here. They're going into small rooms, bits and pieces there. We don't want that. We want to be able to pray in one big hall with 3,000-4,000 people, inshallah. So it's going to be a new Kulliyah Masjid. I would like everyone to support. The only thing, brothers and sisters, we have up till 30th of April to complete the transaction. Otherwise, it will be lost forever. So imagine we have a new masjid, 3,000-4,000 people praying. We'll have a funeral services. We'll have sisters' place, children's place, as well as our man's place as well. So, and the white building will become iconic Islamic museum, awesome Islamic museum. And the red brick building, which you are praying at the moment, will become a dawah center, Islamic center, an educational center for our children's health and well-being. So it will also have an enterprising center as well. It's really an absolute must that we buy this building so the whole parade becomes ours for generations to come. So there's the catch. I would like everyone to be a pillar of this masjid, the new masjid. It's only £1,000 and you can donate it in one go or in small installment, but be part of it. The other thing I want to say is, if you could help us giving a Qardah Hasana, interest-free loan to the house of Allah, whatever amount, 1,000, 5,000, 10,000, it doesn't really matter. Every penny counts. So please do donate generously. If you'd like to do the £1,000, you can take the bank details and set up a standing order, or pay in one going to the bank. Or see us, myself, Sheikh Wadda, Brother Farid, Brother Atiq, Brother Jibril, who's collecting the money, or even Sheikh Sadiq, whenever you see him. Okay, so I'm not going to start collecting now because it's Eid, but please come forward. £1,000, you'll have a wall which says Sadaqah Legacy Wall. That is your founding member. As a founding member of New Kulia Mosque, is only £1,000. And you have a wall with your name, not to show off, but imagine when we leave this dunya, when you are not here, every person that prays, the 4,000 people in the building, will make dua for the people whose names are on the wall. And say, oh Allah, forgive them. Forgive them for their sins in this dunya. What a better way to leave a sadaqah than having your name on a wall where you build the masjid. Brothers and sisters, I don't want to do all that anymore. So please come forward to pay £1,000 as a founding member. We need to be able to collect £500,000 by the end of April. The other things I want to say is, everybody's been given a shoe bag and you've left your shoes in the corridor, but you'll have to pick your shoes, go onto my right, all the way down into the food hall, and then out onto the back here. So there are ushers, there are marshals who'll show you. So we're not going the way you came. We're taking you one-way system right downstairs and then out onto the side car park. And you can all gather in the front for pictures and whatnot. We do have a Kulliam kitchen that we have opened recently, so you'll be able to have tea, coffee. It's a waqf to the masjid. So the Kulliam kitchen and restaurant is open. You buy things, and the profit goes to the masjid. It's part of the masjid, inshallah. So, jazakumullah khair. If you have not paid your zakatul fitr before the imam stands, please make sure you pay. It's £5 per person. Jazakumullah khair for listening to me. And don't forget to connect to your loved ones. Your loved ones, my brothers and sisters, your parents and your brothers. If you have any differences between any friend, give them a call first and break that differences. You'll get the ajr for it, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. May you have a very joyful Eid. Assalamu alaikum. And we'll be starting the khutbah right now. Yeah, prayers, inshallah.
استووا واعتدلوا وصووا بالصفوف. The Eid prayer, for those who are not aware, inshallah, there's different ways of doing it. The way we're going to be doing it today is according to the school of Muhammad ibn Idris al-Shafi'i, which is to pray two rak'at. The only difference that we have in this prayer is that we have takbirat, Allahu Akbar. So after we say the first takbir, before we read the Fatiha, we're going to say seven takbirat, Allahu Akbar. Then obviously we move on and continue the prayer as it is, but then in the second rak'ah, we're going to add an additional five takbirat, inshallah. That's the only difference, seven takbirat in the first rak'ah, and five takbirat in the second rak'ah, and then inshallah we'll do the khutbah, inshallah people should stay and benefit, inshallah ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha illa Allah. Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha illa Allah. Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah walhamdulillah. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah. Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah. Allahu Akbar. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alamin. Ar-Rahmanir Rahim. مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك فإن مع العسر يسرا إن مع العسر يسرا فإذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب الله أكبر. الله لمن حمده ربنا لك الحمد حمدك الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله الله أكبر سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله الله أكبر سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده لك الحمد حمدا كثيرا طيبا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. الحمد لله أرحم الراحمين وخير الخالقين، أحاط بكل شيء علما وأحصى كل شيء عددا، ألا يعلم من خلق وهو اللطيف الخبير. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له ملك السماوات والأرض، يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن، وهو بكل شيء عليم. وسع كرسي السماوات والأرض ولا يؤوده حفظهما، وهو العلي العظيم. وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله، صاحب الخلق العظيم والقلب الرحيم، الهادي إلى صراط المستقيم. اللهم يا علي يا عظيم، أسألك أن تصلي وتسلم على حبيبنا وشفيعنا وقدوتنا محمد الذي أرسلته رحمة للعالمين، وختمت به النبيين، وجعلته سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين. أما بعد، عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله، وما آتاكم الرسول فخذوه، وما نهاكم عنه فانتهوا، وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون. الحمد لله. We praise Allah سبحانه وتعالى. The day of Eid. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla that He accepts this day and He elevates us and alleviates the things that we have in our lives. Alhamdulillah. We know in a hadith that has been narrated by Ibn Hibban that the angels descend on this particular day. The malaika, they descend on this particular day, and they line up in the streets and they come, and Allah Azza wa Jalla has ordered them to come down on the day of Al-Eid, and they appear in places where the Muslims gather. Where the Muslims gather, the malaika also gathered. And they are gathering because the Muslims are gathering for the Eid prayer. The Muslims are gathering for the Eid prayer. And Allah Azza wa Jalla asks these angels, يعني, subhanAllah, يعني, what is that these people, they've gathered, what are they gathering for? And the angels say, they've gathered because to pray, they've gathered to ask for forgiveness, they've gathered to seek your reward and seek your protection. And then Allah Azza wa Jalla asked them, subhanAllah, what is it that they're seeking protection from? He said, they're seeking protection from the hellfire. And Allah Azza wa Jalla, who knows, asked them, have they seen it? And the angel said, no, they haven't. And Allah Azza wa Jalla asked, had they seen it, what would be the difference in them? And the angel said, they'd probably seek your protection even more. And Allah Azza wa Jalla then asks them, what are they asking for? And they said, asking for Jannah, asking for heaven. And Allah Azza wa Jalla asks the angels, and He knows, wal alim. He asked them, have these people seen Jannah? They say, no, they haven't. And Allah asks them, had they seen it, what would they say? They say, Ya Allah, they'll probably ask more. You ask more for Jannah, subhanAllah, and seek it. Allah Azza wa Jalla then says, tell them, and be with my witnesses, be my witness that I have forgiven them their sins. I'm going to protect them from the hellfire. I'm going to enter them into Jannah, alhamdulillah. And Allah, and another hadith mentions that on this day particular, in this particular day, Allah asked the angels, subhanAllah, that they've gathered here. And Allah asked them, subhanAllah, what? They've gathered here because of the Eid. And Allah asked them, tell them, these people, be my witness, tell them that I have forgiven them. Because they are fasted, I've forgiven them, subhanAllah. Because they prayed, I've forgiven them. And they have my rida, my mercy, and my contentment. And if they ask anything of this dunya, from the akhirah, I'm going to give it to them. And if they ask something from the dunya, I'm going to see if it's good for them, I'll give it to them. If it's not good for them, I'll give them something else, something better, and protect them from any bala. Alhamdulillah, wa hakala, mashaAllah. But as we heard, mashaAllah, Ramadan has finished, subhanAllah. And those who have finished Ramadan, subhanAllah, some of you will come with flying colours, some of you will get a good result, some of you get mediocre results, some of you get poor results. Ramadan is a madrasa. Some people are going to graduate, subhanAllah. MashaAllah, those who've read Quran, mashaAllah, tabarak wa ta'ala, there's a reward. Those who've read the Quran with a tadabbur, thinking and pondering, there's a reward. Those who've read the Quran, mashaAllah, and understood it correctly, there's a reward. But subhanAllah, but how many people have read the Quran and they haven't understood? Or how much they've read the Quran and they have kibr in their hearts? Or they read the Quran and they hate other Muslims? Or they read the Quran and the Quran is just words. It's just words for some people. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla that He makes the Quran not just words, but like Sayyidina Aisha said about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كَانُ خُلُقُ الْقُرْآنِ. His character, his mannerisms was the Quran. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a walking Quran. You tell me, 29 days you've heard the Quran behind the Imam. Are you a walking Quran? Can your wife say to you, he's a walking Quran? Can your children look at you and say, he's a walking Quran? His khuluq is a Quran? And if it's not, if that's not the case, then what have you been doing? What have you been listening to? Because you haven't been listening to the Quran. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make our ears and hearts open. Also, subhanAllah, as the brother Mu'min mentioned, subhanAllah, Zakat al-Fitr is an obligation, wajib, you have to pay it on every single individual who you have to pay nafaqah, who you are responsible financially for, you have to pay Zakat al-Fitr. So if you're a husband and you have a wife and you have kids, you have to pay Zakat on yourself, on your wife, and all your kids. SubhanAllah, if you want to transfer the money to somewhere else, to another country, you can, but you have to pay Zakat al-Fitr. In a hadith narrated by Imam al-Tabarani, it is said that the fast, mashaAllah, the fast you've been praying, مُعَلَّقٌ بَيْنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Your fast is suspended. It doesn't go up. It's suspended. It's caught. It's stuck. وَلَا يُرْفَعُ إِلَّا زَكَاةِ الْفِطْرِ. And only paying Zakat al-Fitr is what's going to release it from its being stuck, from it being suspended. But when you pay your zakat al-fitr, then mashaAllah, then your fast is unaccepted. And as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, طُهْرَةٍ لِلصَّائِمِ. Your zakat al-fitr is طُهْر, the صَائِم, it purifies, subhanAllah. Also, subhanAllah, a sign that your fast has been accepted. A sign. We want to know, we understand in our faith that when we fast and we pray, that's not the end of it. We ask Allah, Allah has to يتقبل, Allah has to accept it. Now, if you fast and pray, that's not the end of the job. You ask Allah, Ya Allah, accept my fast, accept my prayer, accept my zakah, accept my Quran, accept these things. And one of the signs, if you want to know, one of the signs that you're fasting, mashaAllah, and your Quran, and your tilawah, and your sadaqah, and all of these things you've been doing, alhamdulillah, a sign that it's been accepted by Allah, is your ability to follow up a good deed with another good deed. In other words, mashaAllah, if you find yourself now after 29 days of fasting or 30 days of fasting, you have a raghbah, you have a desire to worship. You have a desire now to read Quran every day. Even that page or half a page or even one line. You have a desire now, mashaAllah, to come to the masjid. You have a desire now to pray witr. You have a desire now to come qiyam al-layl. MashaAllah, everybody, we had suhoor. Everybody, most people had suhoor. What does that tell you? It tells you that you can wake up before Fajr. That's what it tells you. Everybody prayed witr most nights. What does that tell you? You can pray witr outside of Ramadan. The fact you got up before Fajr and you had suhoor proves that you can get up before Fajr outside of Ramadan and pray your tahajjud and pray your qiyam al-layl. You can do it. You have the ability. But how many people want to do it? So the idea, if you fast, mashallah, after Ramadan, if you fast in Ramadan, the sign that's been accepted by Allah is your desire to follow up a good deed with another good deed. How many people are? They go to Hajj and they come back and they're the same. They pray Jummah after Jummah and they're the same person. No change. This deen is about a change. This deen changes. We look at the Sahaba, how they were. Allah Azza wa Jal changed them. MashaAllah, from the lowest of the lowest to the highest of the highest. This deen changes. But ask yourself, has Ramadan changed you? Has Taraweeh changed you? Has the Quran changed you? Has the fasting changed you? And if it hasn't changed you, then when are you going to change? Ila mata? How long? When are you going to change? When are you going to be yani khuluq al-Qur'an? When? And when you die? And your maqiyamah, it's too late. It's too late, subhanAllah. So, those who are committed, subhanAllah, you want to do something, mashallah, you want to have a sign that Allah has accepted your fast, mashallah, we have 6 days of shawwal. 6 days of shawwal. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hadith, in Sahih Muslim, has said, whoever fasts Ramadan, and we've all fasted, alhamdulillah, and then follows it up with 6 days. Just 6 days. Not a month. 6 days. The reward, كَأَنِهُ صَامَ الدَّهْرِ. It's as if he's fasted the whole year. The whole year, subhanAllah. After fasting Ramadan, 6 more days. Who can't do 6 days? All of you can do 6 days. You've just done 29 or 30 days. 6 more days. And the reward is what? A whole year. A whole year reward, subhanAllah. And another hadith, Imam al-Tabarani mentioned in the hadith that the one who fasts Ramadan and fasts 6 days after it, he comes out sinless as if the day he was born. The day as if he was born, meaning that all the sins, subhanAllah, are wiped away. InshaAllah, the major and minor. InshaAllah, why not? But how many now have the desire to fast 6 more days? How many now are going to say, it's a sunnah. It's a sunnah. Sunnat man. Sunnat man. SubhanAllah, if that's not enough, you ask yourself in the dunyawi sense, in the materialistic sense, most of you work. If somebody says to you, look, work 1 month and I'll give you a wage, and you do it, but I'll give you extra in that 1 month, like Ramadan's extra. And then after that, the boss says to you, look, if you work 6 days after the month, I'm not going to give you 6 days' wage. I'm not going to give you 2 weeks' wages. I'm not even going to give you 1 month's wage. I'm going to give you 1 whole year wage. An annual wage. If for what? If we just fast 6 more days, subhanAllah. Kareem, Jawad, Allah is generous, subhanAllah. How many now? You see yourself now, you have the desire. You're hearing these words. Those who are here and those who are listening, subhanAllah, you're hearing these words. Do you have the desire or not? 1 whole year, worth a reward. 1 whole year. If that was a dunya, someone said, I'll give you £40,000 if you fast 6 days. All of you, mashallah, except Majnoon. All of you will say, Bismillah, give me it now. Allah said, I'm going to give you more than £40,000 or £50,000 or £1 million. I'm going to give you a year worth of reward. And your muqiyamah, you're going to see it. We ask Allah to make us understand, when Allah is generous like this, and you throw it back in His face, and you say, I don't have to. Akhi, you need to. You need to. Akhi, you should want to. Never mind, you should want to. Well, you have no raghba, nothing in your heart. You have no desire, subhanAllah. We ask Allah to make us from those who are desirous. We ask Allah Azza to make us from those who want 1 year's worth of reward. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla that He makes us respect and appreciate His generosity. He doesn't have to. SubhanAllah. So these are things, subhanAllah, as Brother Mu'min mentioned, This is the day that we any silta rahm, contact between families. If you've broken off ties with family, this is not the time to do that. It's time to remedy. It's a time to reconnect yourself with your loved ones. SubhanAllah, how many people here, they have no father, they have no mother. MashaAllah, the mother passed away, the father passed away, and they can't. They can read Fatiha to them, na'am. They can read Quran for them, na'am. But they can't pick up the phone and talk to them. Some of you can do it before it's too late. SubhanAllah, do it, inshaAllah. Make the children in this day happy, SubhanAllah. Some people that in other religions, they have a day of happiness with their children, SubhanAllah. Muslims, we should also be happy. This is our Eid. This is our Eid. Why are we celebrating? Eid is not for the one who wears nice clothes, although it's a sunnah on this day. Eid is for the one whose worship to Allah has increased. And if that's you, MashaAllah, tabarak wa ta'ala. So Allah make us from those who want to ask Allah to accept our fast, accept our prayer, and make us from those who are committed. Rijal, when a rijal, 6 days, bismillah, mataqa'id, bifnasa, be men, committed to this deen. 6 more days that you can do, inshaAllah. And we know, subhanAllah, that as of last night, the shayateen, who Allah Azza wa Jal has locked up, last night, they were free. For a whole month, they haven't seen you. For a whole month, they haven't spoken to you. For a whole month, they haven't whispered to you. But now they're out. And what they want to do, they want to يُخَرِّبُ مَا فِي قُلُوبُكُمْ. They want to ruin what's in your hearts. All the salah you've done, all the talawah you've done, the zakah that you've paid, the fasting, everything you've built in your hearts, they want to ruin it. They can't stand to see you doing good. They don't want that. They want to ruin you. And what they do, they find their way into your heart and try to destroy everything you've built in your heart. All the good work you've done, they want to destroy it. Hakada. SubhanAllah. Some people like that. Shayateen, the insu, shayateen, the jinn. We see it in this day. But don't allow the shayateen to come in and get into your heart and get you angry. And so you divorce your wife. Or you get angry at your children, or you start fighting. And on the first night, SubhanAllah, the first night of Eid, he's already said, divorced his wife, he's had problems with the children, he's angry because the shayateen have gone in, and they haven't found anything in the hearts for some people. They've got ruined it. Don't allow the jinn, the shayateen, to enter into your hearts, to ruin what you've done, the hard work that you've done. Let them come and see that you're strong now. You're not the same person that they could whisper to you a month ago. Now you're a different person. You're a different person. You're mu'min, taqi, nadif, naqi. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make us from those people who the shayateen can't mess around with. The shayateen can't whisper to us. We ignore them, subhanAllah. And we listen to the angel. Allah has given us the angel and the qareen, the shaytan. And the shaytan, when you're born, he's with you. And when you die, he dies with you. And on Yawm al-Qiyamah, you'll see him. And some people, all they listen to is the shaytan that they have with them. We have an angel as well, ilham from the malaika, and ilhamukum, that they inspire you to do good. We ask Allah to make us from those who listen to the malaika, so we become like the malaika, and we don't become like the shayateen. We ask Allah Azza to accept our fast, to accept our zakah. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla, anything we've done wrong in this month of Ramadan, to Allah to forgive us. We ask Allah Azza to yunzur ilayna, to gaze upon us, to gaze upon the Muslims, inshallah. We've come here hoping in Allah's rahmah. We've come here with a good opinion, husn al-dhan billah. We have a good opinion of Allah, that Allah is generous, that Allah wants to forgive us. So we put ourselves in front of Allah and say, Ya Allah, we are here, Ya Allah. Aghfir lana dhunubana. Ya Allah, astur awratana. Ya Allah, arfa'na, Ya Allah. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله اللهم صل وسلم على حبيبنا وشفيعنا وقدوتنا محمد أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله. اللهم صلي وسلم على وعلى آله. الحمد لله. Again, subhanAllah, fast the 6 days. Don't allow shaitan to trick you and say it's just a sunnah. You see that sunnah on Yawm al-Qiyamah, the reward you're going to have, one year worth of reward. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make us one of those people who fast these 6 days, and mashaAllah, it's in your best interest. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to allow us to maintain a connection to the Qur'an. Some people now after Ramadan, khalas, they put the Qur'an away. يهجر القرآن. They put the Qur'an away. They leave it on the shelf. لا, لا, لا, لا, no. Take the Qur'an off the shelf and keep a connection between you and the Qur'an. A connection between you and Allah Azza wa Jal. So that Allah has a connection to you. When you need a connection to Allah, Allah is there for you. But if you're not having a connection, ارتباط بكلام الله, there's no connection to the book of Allah or Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, then what are you going to be left with on Yawm al-Qiyamah by yourself? No Quran, no Salah, no Zakah. We ask Allah Azza to forgive us. We ask Allah Azza ينظر الأخوان في غزة وفي فلسطين وفي السودان وفي اليمن وفي كشمير وفي الصين وفي جميع أنحاء العالم. يا أرحم الراحمين, يا أرحم الراحمين, يا أرحم الراحمين. عباد الله, آواكم الله, حفظكم الله, نصركم الله. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا العالمين يذكركم, وصلوا على نبيكم محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. ولذكر أكبر, والله يعلم ما تصنعون. عيد بارك من عايدين الفائزين المقبولين, والحمد لله رب العالمين. Again, as brother Mu'min mentioned, that as you leave the in one in that direction, inshallah, so the brothers can come in. والحمد لله رب العالمين. يتقبل الله منا ومنكم إن شاء الله.
كرت يعني ما شاء الله
يا زين كيف حالك يا حبيبي انسان يا اخي مدعوه انا قاعد اقول الله يحفظك يا حبيبي.
I'll do the first one, you can follow me, okay?
All right. All right.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله لا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر ولله الحمد اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا أحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر ولله الحمد اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا.
الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله لا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون لا إله إلا الله صدق وعده ونصر عبده وعز جنده وحزم وأصاب وحده لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر ولله الحمد اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله لا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون لا إله إلا الله صدق وعده ونصر عبده وعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر ولله الحمد اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد، الله أكبر كبيرا، والحمد لله كثيرا، وسبحان الله بكرة وأسيلا، لا إله إلا الله، لا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون، لا إله إلا الله، صدق وعده ونصر عبده وعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر، ولله الحمد، اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد، الله أكبر كبيرا، والحمد لله كثيرا، وسبحان الله بكرة وأسيلا، لا إله إلا الله، لا نعبد إلا إياه، مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله وحده، صدق وعده، ونصر عبده، وعز جنده وحزم الأحزاب وحده، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر، ولله الحمد، اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد، الله أكبر كبيرا، والحمد لله كثيرا، وسبحان الله بكرة وأسيلا، لا إله إلا الله، لا نعبد إلا إياه، مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون، لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق
عبد وعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب
وحده لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله لا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر ولله الحمد اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله لا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون لا إله
السلام عليكم sorry just an interruption brothers and sisters a car it's a Hyundai registration number L12GLH you're blocking the car park on the side car park of the masjid So the small car park on the side of the red brick building, please can you move your car L12GLH, L12 Golf Lima Harriet. Please can you move your car, you're blocking the entrance of the car park. So those of you who have parked and blocking others, please move your cars, especially L12GLH. It's a Hyundai. Jazakumullah khair.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله لا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر ولله الحمد اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله لا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر ولله الحمد اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله لا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر ولله الحمد اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد، وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد، وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد، وسلم تسليما كثيرا.
جزاكم الله خير. Thank you so much. Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. On behalf of Britain's first mosque, may I welcome you to the Eid al-Fitr here at this masjid. And from the trustees and the management, I'd like to wish everyone a very happy Eid Mubarak. May you and your family have a very joyful Eid after fasting for 30 days, alhamdulillah. I hope you had a very beautiful Ramadan, and please keep it that way as you are in the blessed month of Ramadan. So I'd like to say Jazakumullah khair, Barakallah feekum for all your beautiful contributions. We were feeding 300 to 500 people every day for iftar here, and you, brothers and sisters, has made that possible by donating for the iftar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you barakah in abundance. Also, the brothers who have given sadaqatul jariyah, again, I'm very grateful. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you and your family reward in abundance. I just want to say that when we are leaving this masjid, when you're leaving the masjid, you had a shoe bag. So we're going to go not the way you came, but you're going to go on my right, across the building, right downstairs, into the food hall, and then out through the restaurants. We have created, a masjid have created a new restaurant, a kitchen. It's open. So you can have your tea, coffee, chips, burger. You can enjoy the family gathering at the back. It's in the food hall. So please make sure you take your shoes and you go round the back, downstairs, into the food hall, and then out through the restaurants. So make use of the restaurant, brothers and sisters. All the proceed goes to the masjid. So even after today, the restaurant will be open for you to come as a family and enjoy the beautiful food freshly cooked by our chefs. So inshallah, this is a waqf to the masjid. So all the proceed goes to the masjid. The second thing I want to say, if you have not paid your zakat al-fitr, which is £5, please pay before the imam starts praying. So you've got a few more minutes to pay your zakat al-fitr. Inshallah, we have a lot of people in the building. Please take care when you're leaving the masjid. Do make use of the cafe area at the back of the food hall. Please, I want to bring your attention to a very special. We're going to build a new Kulia masjid. And as you came, you probably have seen a very ugly looking building next door to the white building, the first mosque. That ugly looking building, which calls Rima's Music, was part of the Kulia masjid 135 years ago. And in 1900, the building got damaged, fire damage, and it was no longer in the hands of Abdullah Kulliam. So it has come back on the sale at £500,000. We have up to 30th of April to complete the transaction. If we don't, we will lose that building forever. Remember, if you look at this post here, the red circle, I'm not sure if everyone can see, but the red circle building, which is Rima's Music, was part of Abdullah Kulliam Masjid 135 years ago. We own the white building. We're going to have the red brick building in our hands soon, where you are praying now. But we need to buy the last building on the right-hand side of the white building. So what I'm saying is £1,000 is the pillar of the masjid. So if you pay £1,000, you become a founding member of New Kulia Masjid. What a beautiful way to donate and leave a sadaqah legacy behind you. So we'll have a wall, a donor's wall. Everybody that pays minimum £1,000, their names will be there, and loved ones. So you can donate £1,000 in your loved ones, in your mother, in your father, in your grandfather, your children, whoever. So please, but most importantly, be part of the pillar of the new masjid. We need to raise. The second thing, if you can give us a loan, Qard-e Hasana, to the house of Allah, we really would appreciate. Whether it's £1,000, £500, or £50,000. It doesn't really matter. Any amount is more than welcome. Together, we can find £500,000, brothers. And this is a very special appeal from us, from the Masjid Committee, from the congregation, to you. If you don't make this happen, we will lose this building forever. And imagine, we're going to build a four-story masjid. Here, people are queuing up. There's no space. There's a small room, this room. There's no shuyukh in that. There's no good feeling if you don't see the imam. In the new masjid, you'll have 3,000-4,000 people in one go, in one room. So it will be very beautifully made, space for sisters, it will be space for funeral space as well, and also we'll have young people space as well. And the white building will become a Islamic museum, the red brick building will become a dawah center, Islamic center, scholars, imams, as well as an enterprise center, because we need to do all of that, inshallah. So I hope you will pay generously. There will be a leaflet giving out to you as you go out. Please make use of that. Or just go to our website and donate online. Jazakumullah. You can go to www.launchgood.com/AQ Mosque. Jazakumullah khair. May you all have a very joyful Eid. If you have not connected with your family, today is the day. If you have an argument or differences against someone, today is the day. Give your first call and say, Assalamu alaikum, Eid Mubarak. All that will be wiped out. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the tawfiq to do more. And inshallah, please come and help us to buy this masjid. Very special appeal today. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum. Please be upstanding for the prayers.
Allahu Ekber. Allahu Ekber. Allahu Ekber. Allahu Ekber. Allahu Ekber. Allahu Ekber. Allahu Ekber. Allahu Ekber. Elhamdülillahi Rabbil Alemin. Er-Rahmanir-Rahim. Maliki yevmiddin. İyyâke ne'abudu ve iyyâke nesta'in. İhdine's-sırâta'l-müstakîme عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. والله الذي لا المصور له الأسماء يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. والتين والزيتون وطور سينين وهذا البلد الأمين لقد خلقنا الإنسان في أحسن تقويم ثم رددناه أسفل سافلين إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات فلهم أجر غير ممنون فما يكذبك بعد بالدين أليس الله بأحكم الحاكمين الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة
الحمد لله الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله أرحم الراحمين وخير الرازقين أحاط بكل شيء علما وأحصى كل شيء عددا لا يعلم من خلق وهو لطيف الخبير وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له ملك السماوات والأرض يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن وهو بكل شيء عليم وسع كرسي السماوات والأرض ولا يؤوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صاحب الخلق العظيم والقلب الرحيم الهادي إلى صراط المستقيم اللهم صلِّ وسلم على حبيبنا وشفيعنا وقدوتنا محمد اللهم صلِّ وسلم عليه وعلى آله الحمد لله الله عز وجل has favored this ummah with many distinguishing features. From amongst the most distinguishing features that Allah has blessed this ummah is with the shahr, the month of Ramadan, الذي أنزل فيه القرآن, the month in which the Qur'an was revealed. And this month, subhanAllah, has finished. And it will go. And it will return. And some of you will see it return. And some of you won't see it return. We ask Allah to make us from those who see it return year after year, year after year. Ameen. Alhamdulillah, mashallah. You fasted. MashaAllah, and you recited the Qur'an, and you prayed Taraweeh, MashaAllah, some more than others, but we prayed, and you gave your zakat al-fitr, and if you haven't given your zakat al-fitr, know that your fast, مُعَلَّقٌ بَيْنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ, the fast is suspended, imprisoned, between the heavens and the earth until you do something. And the only thing that will elevate it, remove it from its suspension, وَلَا تُرْفَعْ إِلَّا بِالزَّكَاةِ الْفِطْرِ, except you pay your zakat al-fitr, then your fast is freed from its suspension. So if you haven't, know that your fast, the hard work you've done, is trapped between the heavens and the earth. And the only thing that will free it is your zakat fitr. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make us from those who pay their zakat fitr. And if you haven't, know that you have to pay it on behalf of yourself and your wife and your children. So make sure you do it. But mashallah, we know in the hadith narrated by Imam al-Bayhaqi, in which, and Ibn Hibban and others, in which we are told by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam of the realities, the haqa'iq, of what is happening around us at this very moment. Do you know, brothers and sisters, that Allah Azza wa Jalla has sent down angels at this time? Angels in the streets, angels right here, right now. And Allah Azza wa Jal asked these angels, what is the reward for a job that is done? Somebody does a job. Someone is told to do something. What is their reward? And the angels say, ya Allah, their reward is that they are paid. They're given their ujra. And Allah Azza wa Jal says, because He is the one that told us to fast, He is the one that has told us to work, Allah then says in relation and in replying to what the reward is, what kind of pay do we get? How much money do we get? Is it money? Is it pounds? Is it dollars? Is it sterling? What? How much do we get? Allah Azza wa Jal tells them, He says, bear witness, Ya malaikati, inni qad ja'altu thawabahum min siyamihim min shahri ramadan wa qiyamihim radaya wa maghfirati. That their reward is not money, that their reward is not any houses or these materialistic things from the dunya that have no meaning in reality, but their reward that I'm going to pay them is I'm content, my rida, Allah is happy with you, and I'm going to forgive them. Now you tell me, brothers and sisters, if you were to buy that with everything in the dunya, would you be able to, you wouldn't be able to buy that. Allah's happiness, rida, Allah's forgiveness, maghfira, la ilaha illallah. And that's why we're celebrating Eid, because Allah has forgiven us. And know that if Allah is happy with you, then He's not going to punish you. Is that not right? He's not going to punish you. If He's happy with you, He's not going to punish you. If you maintain that kind of consistency, if you maintain the momentum, if you maintain the istiqamah, Allah Azza wa Jal will continue being happy with you, will continue to forgive you. And should you fall and you ask Allah for forgiveness, Allah forgives you, but has to be sincere. And this is why we're celebrating on this particular day. And Allah Azza wa Jal says, Ya ibadi, saluni, fa wa izzati wa jalali, la tas'aluni al-yawm shay'an fi jam'ikum li akhiratukum illa a'taytukum. Ask, oh you who are sat here, oh you who are listening, oh you who are listening to this live, oh you sister sat in a room downstairs or wherever you are, Allah has said to you, ask. Now is the time to ask. Raise your hand and ask Allah Azza wa Jalla whatever you want for your akhirah. What do you want for your akhirah? Jannatul Firdaus. What do you want for your akhirah? Ya Allah, get me into Jannah. Whatever you want in your akhirah. Now is the time. Right here. Now is the time to ask. And Allah is saying, ask. And then Allah Azza wa Jal says, and ask for your dunya. Oh brother sat here, or sat in the back room, or walking in the hallway, or outside, or sister sat in the room downstairs, or wherever you are, or those people listening to this live stream or the recording. whatever you want in your dunya, what is it that you need, what is it that you want, that is halal, ask. Now is the time to ask. So whatever you need, subhanAllah, you want your job promotion, you want a better house, you want whatever it is, halal. Now is the time to ask. Allah Jawad, Allah Rahim, Allah Ghafoor. MashaAllah, He's generous on this day. Ask. And Allah Azza wa Jalla then says, if they ask for their dunya, and if it's not good for them, what they're asking for their dunya, if it isn't good for them, Allah knows what's good. That Allah takes it away, but gives you something better. Or dafa' al-bala, Allah removes calamities that may come on you. MashaAllah. Ma'a'azama Rabb. How great is Allah Azza wa Jal that you have this Lord. We're not like the mulhideen, people who don't have a God, people atheists. We have Allah who's generous, subhanAllah. Imagine a world without Allah. Imagine a life without Allah. What kind of life that's going to be? What kind of life? What kind of يعني ذيق وهم وغم? All of these things you're going to have, but we don't have that. We have Allah, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. We have a Nabi, Al-Mustafa, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And we're part of his ummah. خير الأمة أخرجت للناس. The best of ummah brought out to people. بيا أيها الناس. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam has left us with examples. Ummul Mu'mineen Aisha has said that in describing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, كان خلق القرآن, his character, his mannerisms, he was a walking Qur'an. His khuluq was the Qur'an. You want to see the Qur'an walking? The Prophet was the Qur'an walking. Tell me, brother, tell me, sister, oh, you who've been listening, who've been praying Taraweeh, 2, 4, 8, 10, 12, 20 rak'at, listening to the Qur'an every single night. How are you a walking Qur'an? Is your mannerisms in line? Is your khuluq the Qur'an? And if it's not, then when? Ila meta? And when are you going to be a walking Qur'an? When is your manners going to be like the Qur'an? Because you've listened to the Qur'an every night. Allah's words are being told to you. And you're ignoring it, subhanAllah. You're not living by the Qur'an. If you think the Qur'an is just nice words and rhythms and ya mashallah, and that's all you take from the Qur'an, ya waylak. Allah has told you what Allah has told you in the Qur'an. Tell the believers to lower their gaze. We've heard these verses today. We've heard these verses in Ramadan when Allah has told us to be merciful. And you're not. You've heard these verses. You've heard verses telling you to be good. You've heard verses to be telling you to be humble. You've heard verses warning about hell, encouraging you to heaven. You've heard these verses every single night. Tell me, have they affected you? Tell me, have they got into your heart? Tell me, are you khuluq al-Qur'an? And if you're not, then matter. When? How many Ramadans are you going to hear the Qur'an? How many Taraweeh are you going to hear? How many Jum'ahs are you going to hear? Until when is the dunya going to mess you up? You're more concerned about your wealth. You're more concerned about your business than, wallahi, your money and your wealth, as important as it is. It's not that important for you to lose your akhirah. It's not that important. SubhanAllah, ask Allah to make us understand these realities. Brothers and sisters, pay your zakat al-fitr. That's the first thing. The next thing is, subhanAllah, a sign that your fast has been accepted. And some of you may be asking, why do I need to know? I've just fasted. Khalas, I've wajib. I've done the wajib. No, it's not like that, brother and sisters. Not like that. Yes, you've done what you've been asked. Walakin, how do you know Allah has accepted? How do you know? You tell me, do you have a sign? Hal Allah taqabbal am la? Has Allah accepted or not? Is your fast accepted or not? And Allah has the right to reject it. But we have a good opinion of Allah that He accepts. But there's a sign. there's a sign. The ulama say there's a sign for you to realize if your fast has been accepted. Here's the sign. Listen carefully. Because it's important for you to know. The sign is, are you able to continue doing good works now that Ramadan is finished? Are you able to continue? Are you able to continue some kind of connection to Kalam Allah? Are you able to read a bit of the Quran every day? Are you able to do witr like you've done in Ramadan? Are you able to fast 3 days a month? Are you able to continue something, even a little? Are you able to continue? Or as soon as Ramadan is finished, it's like, that's it. No more masjid. Quran's at the top shelf. I'm going to go back to who I was. Alhamdulillah, it's Eid. I'm going to do all the things that I've been wanting to do and dream about in Ramadan. Now I'm not going to do everything. That there is a sign. Your fast has not been accepted. So if you want to celebrate today and do all the things that you shouldn't be doing, pause and tell yourself your fast hasn't been accepted. Well, we ask Allah that He accepts. And for it to be accepted, your commitment, how committed you are to the deen, how committed you are to your akhirah. It's your akhirah. You only lose out you. Nobody else loses, you lose out. But we have something to do. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam has said, whoever fasts Ramadan, and you've all fasted Ramadan, and then follows it up with 6 days. 6 days. Not 6 months. 6 days. It's as if he fasted the whole year. Brother, one whole year. You tell me, in terms of the dunya, those of you who work, you work 1 month and you get your wage. Whatever your wage is, you get that wage. And the person, your boss, gives you extra in that month. Because it's a special month. He gives you extra. Imagine that the boss says to you, listen, I was generous in this month. I give you extra in your wage. But listen, if you fast 6 more days, if you work 6 more days, what they call overtime, 6 days, I'm not going to give you a month wage. I'm not going to give you 2 months' wages. I'm going to give you a wage of a whole year, 1 year annual income. I'm going to give you. And that's a similar example to your fast. Allah Azza wa Jalla told our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, fast Ramadan, fast 6 days, you get a whole year worth of fast. MashaAllah, easy. You've just done 30 days. Give us 6 more days. Start 6 days for tomorrow. By Wednesday, finished. By Wednesday next week, you finished. And what you have in your Qiyamah, you have a whole year worth of fasting in your mizan, in your scales. And you've only done 6 days. But if you're like some people who say, it's only a sunnah, I don't have to do it, that's a bad sign. Because you should want to do it. You should love to do it. Because it's in your best interest to do it. Allah's being generous. We ask Allah to allow us to be respectful, to respect His generosity that He's given us 6 more days to fast, mashallah. Don't be lazy. We ask Allah Azza wa to make us from those who are strong in these days, who continue the good work. Subhanallah, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله اللهم صل وسلم على حبيبنا وشفيعنا محمد أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله. Just to round off, inshallah, when people can go and celebrate their Eid, know that last night, after Maghrib, the shayateen who were shackled, who were not influencing you, who were not telling you, who were not whispering to you, waswasu alaykum, all of these shayateen were locked up. But as of yesterday, Maghrib, after 1 month, now they're free. Now they're going to come back to you. Now they're going to whisper to you. Now they're going to tell you to do the things that you used to do. They're going to come back and say, listen, you've done well in Ramadan. But now relax. Now relax. Do the haram. Go out and do these things. Go look at these things. Go listen to these things. Go touch these things. Know that these shayateen will come back to you. And some of you already have. But know that what they want to do and what they seek to do is that the things you've built in your heart, they want to ruin it. They want to destroy it. They want to ruin you. They want to take your fast and ruin it. They want to take the Quran you've read and ruin it. They want to take your Taraweeh and ruin it. They want to ruin everything for you because they don't like you. They hate you. And we have shayateen in the jinn at the same time. But how strong are you, brother? 1 month now. You've trained yourself. You've trained yourself. You've fasted. You've done Qiyam al-Layl. You've done your Taraweeh. You've done your Tahajjud. You've done your Witr. You've done your Zakat. All, mashallah, you've built and you've built and you've built in your heart strength, immunity. Now what? Don't allow them to make you angry. Don't allow them to say bad things, to put bad things in your heart and your mind. Don't now allow to ruin the hard work that you've done. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to protect our hearts and protect our fast, and for Allah to accept our fast and accept our zakah and accept our salah. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to give us the strength to fast 6 more days so Allah's generosity can be given to us. Subhanallah. We ask Allah to allow us to be respectful. Don't throw it back in Allah's face. He's being kind. Your boss says to you, I'm going to be generous, I'm going to give you extra money. Are you going to throw it back and say, it's okay, I don't need it. I don't need the money. You're not going to say that, are you? You're going to be respectful. So we ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make us respectful of what He has given us. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to give us strength in this, that we are people who are strong, that the shayateen don't waswasu alayna, they don't ruin it, they don't allow us to say bad things to our wives. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make us, to make our khulq, the khulq of the Quran. So when Aisha said, khulqul Quran, the mannerisms, his mannerisms of the Quran. The Prophet's wife said that. Does your wife say that? Can your wife say that about you, that you are khulqul Quran, zawji, mashallah, khulqul Quran? Are you able to say that about your wife? And if not, then when? Until meta? When are you going to hear the Quran and change? We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make us from those who change. We ask Allah to make us from those who pay the zakat of fitr. We ask Allah to give us the strength to fast 6 days. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to bless this masjid, to bless the imam, mashallah, to bless the people, mashallah, the people who do khidmah, malik, and mashallah, and mu'min, all these people that we don't see, we do the hard work. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to allow us to increase the building here, to buy this other part of the building. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to give us tawfiq. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, to accept our fast, to accept our zakah, to accept our Quran, to accept our taraweeh. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to allow us to live long enough till the next year. Subhanallah, Ramadan will come back. And some of us will be back, and some of us won't be back. We Allah ask Allah to make us from those who return year after year. And we ask Allah, if we've done anything wrong, any shortcomings in this month, we ask Allah to forgive us, to show us His generosity. And final thing, brothers and sisters, be kind to your wife. Be kind to your children. Wife, be nice to the husband. Give it, be nice to him. Husband, be nice to the wife. Children, be nice to your mum and dad, mashallah. And parents, be nice to your children. And subhanallah, pick up the phone. As Brother Mu'min mentioned, some people, their mother's still alive, their father's still alive. Pick up the phone, talk to them. Eid Mubarak. Some people, their mother's father's dead, and they can't pick up the phone. But if your mother and father's still alive, mashallah, pick up the phone, get their dua, and we ask Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, أخواننا في غزة, أخواننا في فلسطين, أخواننا في اليمن, أخواننا في العراق, أخواننا في أفغانستان, أخواننا في السودان, أخواننا في الصين, أخواننا في جميع أنحاء العالم, يا أرحم الراحمين, يا أرحم الراحمين, يا أرحم الراحمين, فرج على المسلمين, والحمد لله رب العالمين.
الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد
الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله
أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا
إله إلا الله
ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد
وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد
وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد
وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر
لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا
لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر
ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله وحده نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين لو كره الكافرون اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا. الله أكبر
الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا.
Assalamu alaikum, brothers. We have a lot of people outside queuing, so we're going to give them about 7 to 10 minutes, if that's okay. It's the last prayer, so we want to give the opportunity to people who are queuing to get inside the building. About 7 minutes or so, inshallah.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا.
Brothers and sisters, just a little thing. It's sunnah, so say it out loud. جزاكم الله خير. It's sunnah. Show the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by remembering him on this day. جزاكم الله خير.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله بصيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا
لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My dear brothers and sisters, welcome to the Eid al-Fitr at Britain's First Mosque. So those of you who have joined us for the first time, you are praying at Britain's First Mosque, which was established by an Englishman way back in 1887, 137 years ago. Jazakumullah khair, barakallah fikum for all your beautiful contributions throughout the holy month of Ramadan. And we've been feeding 300 to 500 people every day for iftar, and it is you, brothers and sisters, who have contributed to that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you barakah in abundance. Also, as you know, we are embarking on purchasing a new building, which is called the Rimas Music Building, right next to the White Building. And this, as those who are upstairs, you can see in the red square, you have this building called Rimas Music. And that used to be Abdullah Kulliam's masjid 135 years ago. And he lost it through fire damage in 1900. The building is in private ownership and it has come up for sale. So we've been really working hard for them to sell it to us. So we're buying that at £500,000. The market value is about £700,000. So we don't want that, we'll lose that building. It's going to be the new Abdullah Kulliam Masjid. Now, as you can see, we're praying in the every single small rooms, which you don't get the hasana, you don't get the a feel for it. So we want to build a purpose-built masjid where 3,000-4,000 people can pray in one go in large rooms. So I need your support. The most important thing, brothers and sisters, we have up till 30th of April to complete the transaction. And that's the deadline that we have. Otherwise, they will sell it to a private seller. Imagine if it goes out to a non-Muslims, it could be a restaurant with selling alcohol, it could be a nightclub, it could be a restaurant or a hotel. We don't want that. It used to be the masjid where Kulliam prayed in 135 years ago. What I would ask you is to become the pillar of that masjid by donating £1,000. You don't have to donate £1,000 straight away if you don't have it. You can set a standing order £10, £20, £50, whatever you can afford. But be the brick, be the pillar of this new Kulia Masjid. This is our heritage. It's the first mosque in Britain, brothers and sisters. And be part of that. So if you can also give a loan to the House of Allah, any amount, from 500, 200, 1,000 to £50,000, we will pay that back within 3 to 6 months, inshallah. So do please come forward. Go to our collection point. It's www.launchgood.com/AQ Mosque. I've been giving out some leaflet. Is there, or go direct to our website and you can pay online. Or you can pay into the masjid as well. Myself, Sheikh Wadda, Sheikh Sadiq, Brother Farid, Brother Atiq, Brother Jibril, anybody you find, you can contact them, inshallah. So £1,000, everyone, to become the pillar of the new masjid, inshallah. Say takbir, Allahu Akbar. I'm not going to stand here and collect the money as I've done during Ramadan. I'm going to leave it in your hands. It's you, me, us. If we don't buy this building, we will not have it forever. And we're going to have a space for sisters. We're going to have a janaza space. We'll have space for children and also as well as for adults. And the white building will become an Islamic museum, a center of excellence for learning. And the red brick building where we are praying now will become a madrasa. It will have a dawah center. It will have health and well-being, sisters, children's nursery, and educational center. A center for excellence for all our children and their children's children. We have opened a new restaurant at the back, and therefore the proceed goes to the masjid. So it's owned by the masjid, and anything you buy, the proceed comes to the masjid. We've got to make it sustainable as we go forward, inshallah. Now, the most important thing, you've had a carrier bag with your shoes. You're not going back the way you came. So on my right, you'll follow on your right, right to the corridor, at the back in the food hall. There'll be some refreshments, and we have the restaurant there. So you'll exit out that way, through the food hall, into the restaurants, and as you go. So please do donate generously as you're leaving the masjid. I would like to, on behalf of the trustees and the management, may I wish you all a very happy Eid Mubarak. May you have, and your family, a very joyful and a wonderful day in this blessed month of Ramadan, in the blessed month of Eid. Sorry about that. It's on this special day of Eid. I'm talking too fast, aren't I? Jazakumullah khair. Really, if you have not spoken to a friend for a long time, please give them a call. Don't forget to call your parents, mom and dad. I don't have one, so I can't call them. I can only make dua. Make dua for the deceased who are no longer with us. If you have a problem or a differences between any person, please give them a call. Be the first one to mend that relationship. Jazakumullah khair. Please be upstanding for the prayers. Can I ask every brothers to step one step forward? So we've got brothers waiting there to get in. Just one step forward. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum.
صلاة العيد أفاضت الله just a reminder, switch your phones off, جزاكم الله خير. There's extra takbirs, as you know, in the Eid prayer. It will be 7 extra takbirs in the first rak'ah and 5 extra in the second rak'ah, inshallah. The sunnah is to raise your hands with takbir and jahar and say out loud, Allahu Akbar. جزاكم الله خير. استووا.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم الله أكبر
سمع الله لمن حمده ربنا لك الحمد
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا نحمده سبحانه ونشهد أن لا إله إلا هو له كل شيء وله كل شيء وهو مليكه الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله الحمد لله الذي أنعم علينا بنعمة الإسلام وما أعظمها من نعمة فبسبب الإسلام أصبحنا خير أمة أخرجت للناس والحمد لله الذي أنعم علينا بنعمة القرآن الذي بسببه لن نضل ولن نزيغ أبدا والحمد لله الذي أنعم علينا بنعمة شهر رمضان الذي بسببه يغفر الله تعالى لنا ما قدمنا من ذنوبنا وما أخرنا من الآثام All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala All praise and thanks are due to Him Only Him subhanahu wa ta'ala Firstly by guiding us to Islam And there is no greater favor than that ibadallah And all praise and thanks are due to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us the Qur'an with which we will never go astray if we follow it. And all praise and thanks to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala for blessing us and giving us the month of Ramadan as a chance to get closer and closer to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala and a chance for us to get our sins expiated
عباد الله أيها المسلمون، لقد مضى رمضان شهر البركة وشهر الخيرات، شهر الصبر والانتصارات، شهر القرآن والصلاة والصيام والقيام، عاش فيه المسلم أقرب لصورة الملائكة. إذا بدأ الفجر امتنع عن الطعام والشراب والشهوة، وإذا دخل الليل وقف يناجي ربه تبارك وتعالى ويدعوه سبحانه وتعالى ويسبح بحمده. صام المسلمون أو صام المسلم رمضان إيماناً بما فرضه الله تعالى عليه، واحتساباً بانتظار الثواب من الله تبارك وتعالى. عباد الله، عاش المسلمون في رمضان شهر امتثالاً للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وللسنة النبوية، وامتثالاً فيه، وامتلأت المساجد من المصلين والمعتكفين والقارئين للقرآن، امتلأت المساجد ما بين راكع وساجد وقائم لله تعالى. عاش المسلمون شهراً والقرآن بأيديهم، يقرؤون كلام الله سبحانه وتعالى كلمات النور أو يستمعون إليها. عاش المسلمون شهراً وصدقاتهم توزع ليلاً ونهاراً سراً وعلانية على الفقراء والمساكين، وهم ينتظرون أجراً والثواب من الله تبارك وتعالى. Brothers and sisters, the month of Ramadan has came to an end, and it's sadly come to an end. It was the month of blessing and goodness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where every one of us felt closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we now wish that all the months were Ramadan. The way we got closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we understood what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted from us, and we kept clean with everything that we do, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would accept our fasting. It was the month of patience, the month of victory for ourselves over ourselves, the month of Quran, of prayer and fasting. Muslims have lived during this month in a state close to those of the angels, subhanallah. As soon as dawn entered, they stopped eating and drinking. And as soon as the night entered, they stood in prayer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeking His forgiveness and mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, Muslims have fasted Ramadan in obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the command of their Creator subhanahu wa ta'ala, and hopeful of getting His reward on the Day of Judgment, bi-idhnillah. They have lived a month during which the mosques were filled, the mosques were packed day in, day out, day and night, worshippers, and in the air was filled with recitation of the Quran, with the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have lived the month of charity, giving both in private and in public, day and night. Ayyuhal Muslimun, لقد بينا رسولنا صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث الصحيح أن للصائم فرحتين، فرحة يوم فطره أي يوم العيد، وفرحة بلقاء ربه تبارك وتعالى. وها نحن ننعم بالفرحة الأولى، فرحة يوم الفطر، هذا يوم العيد، فرحة بالطاعة، فرحة بالعبادة لله سبحانه وتعالى، فرحة بالصيام والقيام والقرآن والصدقة. ونسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى القبول، نسأل الله تعالى أن يمن علينا بالفرحة الثانية، وهي أن ندخل الجنة من باب الريان بإذن الله. Brothers and sisters, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our guide, our Prophet, the Messenger, our Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us in a hadith that every fasting person will have two moments of happiness. One, when he finishes his fast, and the second, when he meets his Lord. And here we are, we're witnessing the first moment of happiness, the day of Eid. We are happy that we obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's command and worshipped Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us and give us the second moment of happiness, which will be when He subhanahu wa ta'ala admits us to the Jannah through Bab al-Rayyan bi-idhnillah, insha'Allah. عباد الله، تتميز أعياد المسلمين بعدة مميزات لا توجد في أعياد غير المسلمين. من هذه المميزات أولاً أن الذي شرع واختار يوم الفطر ويوم الأضحى ليكون عيداً للمسلمين ليس أحداً من الناس، ولا ملكاً من ملوك الأرض، ولا مجموعة من الناس أو البشر، بل الذي اختاره هو رب العزة الله سبحانه وتعالى، كما جاء في الحديث الذي رواه أبو داود عن أنس رضي الله عنه قال: قدم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم المدينة ولهم يومان يلعبون فيهما، فقال: ما هذان اليومان؟ قالوا: كنا نلعب فيهما في الجاهلية. فقال رسولنا صلى الله عليه وسلم: إن الله قد أبدلكم بهما خيرا منهما يوم الأضحى ويوم الفطر. Brothers and sisters, there's a difference between our celebrations and other people's celebrations. Our Eid festival, firstly, Muslims is special. Why is it special? Because the one who chose this occasion of Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha wasn't a prince, he wasn't a king, wasn't a human. He was the kings of kings, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We obey him subhanahu wa ta'ala when he says fast. And we obey him subhanahu wa ta'ala after bi-idhnillah he bestows his favor upon us and gave us the tawfiq to rejoice and celebrate. Anas, may Allah be pleased with him, narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he came to Medina, he found the people of Medina, they had 2 days of celebrations. So he asked, what are those 2 days? They said, these are days of celebrations from the pre-Islamic period. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah has given you instead of them 2 days that are better than them, the day of Al-Adha and the day of Al-Fitr. Ibadallah. وثانيا أعياد المسلمين تأتي دائما بعد طاعة وعبادة لله تبارك وتعالى، وليست تأتي كما يفعل بعض الناس احتفالا بميلاد أحد أو موت أحد. فعيد الفطر جاء بعد ركن من أركان الإسلام العظيم ألا وهو الصوم، وبعد شهر الصدقة الفطر، وبعدها بإذن الله صدقة الفطر. وعيد الأضحى يأتي بعد ركن كله بركة وكله خير، وهي عشر ذي الحجة، ويختم بيوم النحر أو يوم عرفة. Secondly, our Eids always happen after occasions, brothers and sisters, after worship, and not like other celebrations. We do not celebrate because the birth of someone or the death of anyone. We celebrate to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made give us some worship before that. So before Eid al-Fitr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made Ramadan, Sawm, one of the pillars of Islam. So we have to go through the Sawm to seek the celebration after. And Eid al-Adha likewise comes after another pillar, which is Hajj. وثالثاً تتميز أعياد المسلمين بأن أول احتفالها عبادة الله تعالى، فيبدأ يوم العيد بالغسل والتطيب والخروج إلى المسجد لصلاة العيد مع المسلمين، يذكرون الله تعالى ويتبسمون لبعضهم ويهني بعضهم بعضا. يقول المسلم لأخيه: تقبل الله منا ومنك الطاعات، كما كان صحابة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يفعلون. Thirdly, brothers and sisters, our Eids themselves are also filled with worship of Allah. So the day of Eid starts with having a bath, bathing and putting on perfume and going out to the mosque, to the masjid, with the fellow Muslims, your brothers and sisters. We greet each other and pray together as one ummah, one community. We pray for each other by saying, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your deeds. رابعا عباد الله في يوم العيد يتقرب المسلم إلى الله تعالى بأنواع كثيرة من الطاعات والعبادات، فهو يتبسم في وجه أخيه وهي صدقة، وهو يتصدق من ماله على الفقير والمسكين والمحتاج، وهو يبر والديه، وهو يصل رحمه، ويزور المريض، وهو يغفر لمن أساء إليه ويسامح من أساء إليه. Fourthly, عباد الله, on the day of Eid, there are many opportunities, even on the day of Eid, of worship. Smiling when meeting each other, that's a sadaqah itself. Giving money in charity is a sadaqah. Being obedient to our parents, being dutiful to our parents, visiting them, visiting our relatives, visiting the sick, and forgiving each other for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه فيا فوز المستغفرين. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله العظيم وبحمده بكرة وأصيلا. أيها المسلمون، ونحن في فرحة العيد يجب أن لا ننسى أن ندعو لإخواننا المسلمين في كل مكان الذين لا يفرحون بالعيد بسبب القتل والتشريد
لا يجب أن ننسى أن ندعو الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يحقن دماء المسلمين. نسأل الله تعالى أن يتقبل منا ومنكم صالح الأعمال. اللهم أعد علينا أمثال هذا العيد والمسلمون على دينهم مطبقون ولراياته رافعون ولشعوبهم موحدون وللقدس والأقصى محررون. اللهم ارحم شهداءنا واشف مرضانا يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين ارحمنا يا ناصر المظلومين انصرنا يا موحد القلوب وحدنا. And lastly, عباد الله, while we're living these days of happiness, we must make sure not to forget our brothers and sisters around the globe who have also just finished the month of fasting. And some of them, sadly, are still fasting because why? They've got no food, no drink. But the difference between you and me and them, the difference between us is we've got food, we've got drink, we've got new clothes, we wake up, we see our children, we wake up, you see your wives. MashaAllah, we go to visit our parents, our friends, happiness all around us. Some of them are waking up to losing their daughter, losing their son, losing their parents. Waking up, even if they're as a family, they're still there. They wake up with no food, nothing to celebrate, nothing to break a fast, even though it is haram to fast on the day of Eid, but they continuously carry on their fast. Ibadallah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to elevate all the stress of them, elevate occupation, inshaAllah, bi'idhnih, to give happiness to each single person, one of them. بإذن الله تعالى اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين اللهم وحد صفوف المسلمين اللهم احفظ المسلمين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك من طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا متعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا أبدا ما أبقيتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا وانصرنا على من عادانا وآذانا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا غاية رغبتنا ولا إلى النار مصيرنا. عباد الله تقبل الله طاعاتكم وكل عام وأنتم بخير وعيدكم مبارك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Thank you.
Thank you.